What a huge result for Inter. We'll talk about the ramifications of that game with regards to the title race in a moment. But let's just focus on the 90 minutes, because it is an old cliche, a game of two halves. But this just absolutely epitomised that.
Do you know, I'm surmising here, obviously, but I get the feeling Antonio Conte went into that dressing room at halftime and said, do you realise we can go top of the league here today?
Yeah.
Because that was a kick up the backside team talk, if there ever was one. We know AC Milan have had more swagger since Zlatan's gone back. We know they've been playing better. But to allow Milan to control the game like they did in that first half, and for Inter to be so deep and so passive, for a side that's in the position they're in and ultimately being the home side today, was a real shocker. Second half, absolutely brilliant.
Yeah. So you mentioned about, let's talk about the 90 minutes. I think let's talk about halftime. Because halftime comes at the wrong time for Milan. They were so superior to Inter at that time. All the momentum. They scored the late goal in the first half and you're thinking, wait a minute, is this really happening? And then you're asking the questions that Craig just mentioned about Inter. Is that, do they know what's at stake here? They go into halftime, it's almost as Milan just sat there and said, we were really good.
Yeah.
We are in it to win it. All right, this job done. And obviously not job done. Come out to second half, the intensity of Inter picked up through the midfield, the intensity of every 50-50 ball, the freedom that guys like Calhanoglu had in the first half, they did not have in the second half. There were challenges for the ball. Inter was winning every second ball, every challenge, everything that they were doing was picking up the energy and the intensity. Well, that goes and alludes to the point that Craig just mentioned, is it must have been a beautiful halftime speech by Conte with energy, with intensity, demanding something from their teams, demanding an urgency that they did not have, that they showed in that second half. That was impressive by Inter, the way they came back
but
in this game.
How does that happen from a player's perspective? They know they could have gone top of the table. They know it's a big game against a City rival, yet they were so poor in the first half. Yeah. You need somebody to tell you that at halftime? How does that work?
Footballers, soccer players. Sometimes they need a kick up the backside. Doesn't matter if they're millionaires or internationals, doesn't matter. Sometimes you just subconsciously get into a bit of a negative state of the game. And one of the things they did in the second half, back three further up, wing backs further up, hence the midfield further up, and more support and a closer link to the front two, Lukaku and Alexis Sanchez, who it was. And that just worked better for them. And, you know, at the end of the day, I know Rebic was floating around Zlatan Ibrahimovic, but why do you have to sit so deep? A 38-year-old is not going to run in behind you.
Right.
You can squeeze the game up a little bit, get some pressure on, and you know, try and get on top of them. That's what they did. We just know Antonio Conte's character. He's one of the fieriest managers in European football. And I'm telling you, without Ali's seen it, I've seen it, we've seen some managers that will take the paint off a wall at half-time. And I know he's one of them.
Mm.
Some of the guys at Chelsea would have said before, when he's not happy, he lets you know. Worryingly, you can't continue to get performances like that in the first half and bounce back with such a special performance in the second half. That can't always happen. But I think just in terms of the game itself and the 3 points, clearly, he'll be delighted.
There are two sides to the story as well. While Inter did pick up that urgency and that energy in the second half, you also have to say that all the doubts and shortcomings of Milan also showed up in the second half, where now it's 2-1. Yeah. Now it's 2-2. And now you're hesitant because now you go back to the early struggles of the season, to the reasons as to why you're so far back, to the reasons you're leaning on Zlatan to be the guy who scores an important goal for you. All of a sudden, that possession that was so fluid in the first half and everything, all that interchange was not happening as naturally, and you saw Milan then take a step back. Once they took that step back and Inter took a step forward, this game was always going to be very difficult for Milan to win.
Look at the De Vrij header, sorry. And you know, Ali said it on the highlight, it's just such a special header. You can't blame anybody.
Right.
The marking was good. Mm. They had everybody picked up. I think it was Romagnoli who was picking him up. He was touch tight to him, but somehow he managed to get steep down and look this thing into the far corner. And I think when you see that go in as an Inter fan, you think, this is going to be our day now. Because he's probably never going to score a goal like that again, never mind in one of the biggest games in Italy. Heck of a turnaround from Inter Milan. Was impressed by Milan from where they've come from before Zlatan arrived. But still for them, much work to be done.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. And for more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for premium content and live streaming, subscribe to ESPN+.